Welcome back to Reach Around Radio, the hottest new show on the internet.
Reach Around.
You can hear us every week right here on LATalkLive.com. Mondays at 5, Thursdays at 3 on the West. In studio, POTUS, Speedy.
What's happening?
TDP. Mr. Three Knox, bitch.
Special happy birthday to Barack Obama once again.
Commander-in-Chief.
And as we've been promoting it, every Thursday, we have Talent Thursday. So we have our first victim.
Is he a victim?
No, I'm just playing.
A coaster or a cut?
We're going to see if it's a coaster or a cut. We're going to get to that in a minute.
Downloading it now.
But first, we do have a caller we'd like to get to.
We do?
Yes, no, we have a caller. Caller, what's your name and where you calling from?
Yeah.
Not this again.
Yeah, we're going to get it fixed one day.
We got the goddamn call. Green Acres phone system.
Yo, welcome to the show. What's that? Okay, cool. 323-247-7443 is the actual number to call.
I think we got to give them like a second or two.
Is that what a second delay? Okay, cool.
Click in.
Are they there now? I don't want to try again. I'm scared.
Hold on.
The call waiting. Caller, welcome to the show. What's your name and where are you calling from?
Hi, this is Mona from New Orleans.
How you
doing,
Mona?
Welcome.
All right. I don't know if you guys talked about Barack. He won a Grammy.
He did.
He did win a Grammy.
For what?
For his
speech?
His audiobook.
The book.
For his audio version of Dreams from
That's
My
right,
Father.
Mona.
Way to go, Mona.
Yeah. I just looked it up online. I'm not that smart.
Oh.
Do you sleep with the fan on, baby?
No, I don't sleep with the fan on, Speedy. I'm sorry.
Oh, all right. Lovely people call.
Well, thank you so much for your
call.
Thank
you, Mona.
We
appreciate
it.
Thanks for listening to us.
We have another caller on the line. Caller, what's your name? Where are you calling from?
Oh, you just cut him off.
What's your name? Where are you calling from?
Hello.
Bobby.
Hey, what's up, man?
You said Bobby?
Hi, who's it?
You said, who's it?
It's Pizza Hut. What you want? Take out or deliver?
Take out, please. A medium slice.
Okay.
What up?
What's up, dog? Who's this?
King Tut, man. He's stoked. What's back?
King Tut!
Yay, Amia!
What's up, Pimpin?
Hey, 40, baby. Up in this car, King of Straight.
Yeah.
What?
What's happening?
So you got an unknown fact about Barack since it's his birthday?
Are
I know you
do. Banging on this? I mean.
Yeah, man. You got to raise that debt ceiling. You know what I mean?
Hold on, we got a call.
He already actually raised the debt ceiling.
Shouts out to the Eastmont Mall.
He said Barack has
to
raise the debt ceiling.
Shouts out
to Mark Curry. What's up, Playboy?
Yeah.
Mark Curry, Royal Park. 73 Lockwood, Wells Street. What's cracking?
Okay.
Are you
here? 98 Sunnyside.
That's me.
Hammer, High Street Bank Boys. What's up?
What about 66 Bill?
Hey, boy.
All right. Thanks.
Shout out to Soul Beat. Moving on.
Hey, when niggas get on there and shout out every street and gang. They
King Tut, Oaktown. You like them kind of guys.
I do, but not
you
the
like
radio.
Them real, oh, okay. You want to shout out while you're hitting it?
Yeah.
Shout out to Claudia.
Pass them a scout.
Okay.
All right. Caller, what's your name? Where you calling from?
Hello.
Yeah, what's that?
Hello, who am I speaking to?
Everybody's a comedian. Ain't this a bitch?
But really not, though.
Welcome to Reach Around Radio. What's happening?
I'm up in charge there.
Is this guy black?
Who is it?
I'm white. My name is Michael White.
How you doing, Michael
okay.
White?
Go ahead and get to the funny part.
I want to speak to the man in charge because I want to complain about this Barack Obama foolishness that I'm being subjected to.
Oh, really? What's the problem with Barack Obama?
All you have to do is click off.
Yeah, if you turn your radio off, you ain't got to be subjected to none of this.
Right.
Shit. Yeah, huh? Matter of fact, we're going to help you.
Suck some,
huh? Next off. We had to deal with it no more.
Okay.
Who all we right. got in the house here?
We have a good friend of mine.
Claudia.
His name is Rashad McCants, NBA player, and now he's actually a rapper, and he's actually quite talented. That's why I wanted to bring him in. So, ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Mr. Rashad McCants. Welcome to Reach Around Radio. Hey.
NCAA champion.
They got to turn you on over there.
Yeah,
turn them on.
See everything's on.
Yeah,
delay reaction.
Why don't you scoot it a little closer to myself? Can you? Oh, no. Don't move the mic.
That's easy, POTUS.
Yeah.
Yes,
I that can. Window's closing.
Yeah, he's not on. No.
Okay.
Is it working?
Hold on 2 seconds.
We check, check. There we go.
Yeah. Welcome to the show, Rashad.
What's going on? What's going on?
Oh, I got a good voice, too. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Did you drop an egg?
Yes, twice.
So are you still playing? Last time I saw you, were working out.
Yes,
so
sir.
Are you still playing? Or?
Oh, yeah. Definitely. I just want to address.
Him?
I just want to address that that's not my name anymore.
Okay. Right?
That's why you
that's
changed,
what I'm talking
you changed
about.
Your name, and I wanted you to go ahead.
What is it changed to?
King Sonny Black.
King Sonny Black.
Like, is that two keys? Two K's? Or
no, two keys.
One K. One K. Yeah.
King Sonny.
No, you
King
for Sonny real changed
it? He's for real. Hilarious. So what is behind that? Like, what does that mean exactly?
Well, I've always been infatuated with royalty and being a king. And, you know, when you're born, you don't have control of what your name is.
Right.
Your mother does. Yeah. And I want my name to be King Sonny Black. And I want to start my own line of children
of children,
baby Sonny Blacks.
Just my own line, just my own bloodline, my own.
Well, how does your family feel about that, changing your name?
My family's comfortable with anything I'm happy doing. As long as I'm happy, it's all that matters.
So, okay. King Sonny Black, do you have a whole bunch of Crown Royal bags at your house? Yeah. That's what I'm talking. He's a real dude. He's a real dude.
So, if I'm the police and I pull you over, do I go King?
King.
First name? Sonny?
Oh, no, all together.
All together?
King Sonny Black.
Yes. Okay.
So, Sonny's not the middle name?
No.
Okay.
King Sonny Black, all one.
So, we can't call you King then?
You can call me whatever you want to call me.
All right, Rashad.
KSB. KSB in this bitch. Bitch.
Straight up.
All right, tell us about the album.
No album. We have a collection, a group collection. Basically, YBG is our brand. And we've put together a group that is going to pretty much take over the industry.
Wow.
Our company alone is going to be able to build such a brand that everybody's gonna love our music just from the brand alone. You know, we're building an urban brand that is gonna pretty much maximize our whole market.
And YBG stands for
Young Boss Generation.
Okay.
Young Boss Generation.
And we spoke about this. It's not just music, right? It's an entertainment company. Yes. So it's just you want to do films and television,
full scale,
everything, right?
Everything. You know, we know that there's pretty much what we discuss as a lockout in the industry,
mm-hmm.
as far as basketball, football, you got entertainment, you got actors, and you got actual musicians that can't get work. We know that there's an independent industry that is dire need of leadership,
mm-hmm.
and that's where we come in. We're going to give that leadership to all the independent artists who are looking for that breakout that they can't get from the major labels, because the major labels only play 20 artists every day.
So if somebody wanted to send you something or get at you, what do they have to do?
Reach us at info@ybgent.com, and that's our website, ybgent.com. Mm-hmm. You can reach us there, and we'll listen to the music. We'll get back. Like, that's one thing that we do. Mm-hmm. We're not talkers.
Right.
You know? We are about action, and we're definitely not desperate. We're very aggressive.
That's hot.
Now
I need a shirt. I need a goddamn shirt.
First things first. Now most people know you from being in the NBA.
Right.
And
how's the jump?
He was drafted by the Minnesota Timberwolves in 2005.
14th overall.
Played for Sacramento Kings and Houston Rockets.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so how is that? Now you're not in the NBA right now. What's your status right now as far as playing ball?
Well, pretty much I've been locked out for about 2 years now. Can't get a job.
Wow.
In the NBA.
What do you mean
right
locked
now?
Out? Now we talked about some of that before. Mm-hmm. So what do you mean? Can you tell the listeners?
So you mean to tell me you've been King Sonny Blackballed?
Yeah. King Sonny Blackballed out the league.
Man. Yes,
that is perfect. Yeah. That is perfect, man. You can't get no better than
King really Sonny Blackballed.
It can't get no better than that.
Okay. Yeah, break it down for us. What does that mean?
Well, I mean, with the ability that I have, there's pretty much, you know, no possible way that we're in the situation 2 years not playing in the NBA, but it gave me an opportunity to seek other venues and avenues. But being locked out, it's kind of like nobody would talk to me.
Wow.
No GMs, no workouts, no 10-day contracts, not even training camp. I haven't been in training camp for 2 years.
Is that for all the players or just you right now?
Just me.
Now, are you missing the game? Are you missing? Because I'm a little old. Me and Barack same age, and I still want to go play ball every day.
Right.
So are you like, I gotta get go in the
that
gym?
She can jump.
I mean, with the passion that I have for the game and that I had for the game, my whole perception has been just misunderstood completely. Mm-hmm. Just people took my passion for the game and flipped it and called me arrogant, cocky, whatever it is. But sometimes you get burnt out on trying to do right so much, and everybody keeps pushing you and telling you that you're this guy, you're this guy. Right, you can never change yourself from being the bad guy to the good guy. Mm-hmm. So, you know, you often hear that, you know, you live so long as the hero long enough to see yourself turn into the villain. And then it's like, wow, how did I get to this point?
So is it because, do you feel it's because it's a personal issue they have with you, with they claim that you have an attitude and really you feel like you've just been more misunderstood because you're passionate about what you believe in and how you feel? Is that really what the story on Rashad McCants is?
Well, pretty much the story on me is I'm Hollywood, as you can tell. You know, I got
you did come in with glasses on and a robe.
Yeah.
Smoking jacket.
So you know what I mean? So
that was 104 outside.
Yeah. So that's a lot of the feedback that I get trying to figure out answers. Just try to figure out, like, you know, tell me something, man. Somebody give me some clues on why they don't want to, you know, get at me. And I hear, you know, you're Hollywood, you dated such and such. And
who is such and such?
Who'd you date?
Khloe Kardashian.
What?
Y'all know.
Peanut brittle out here.
I didn't know that.
Yeah,
was it you or was it King?
He said he popped the cherry.
You popped the cherry.
Not the cherry, but the
basketball
publicity cherry. Yeah.
Got you.
So how was that? Was it like she wasn't as famous at the time, right? And then it did, or was she?
No, wasn't.
And then I remember on the blogs reading something about, you know, big deals made, you cheated on her and she was like so hurt and all this. Do you care to address that?
Of course.
Please do.
There's a lot of it. I mean,
Reach Around Radio that, exclusive.
Yes, that typical situation kind of affected my basketball career because women started perceiving me as a womanizer.
Got you.
On a fake, false, made up scripted show.
Really?
Which had nothing to do with me, which is why I wasn't on the show. They just used my name because I signed the waiver for them to use my name.
Let me get this right. So you were dating her in real life, and then she goes on her show and talks about you without you being able to appear on her show?
We weren't dating in real life.
It was fucking.
Yeah. So
I'm gonna get it out there. I let exactly.
Yeah, really.
White girl, you fuck. And sisters, you did.
I mean, we had conversations. It was, you know, it was a situation where they wasn't giving me the opportunity to play on my contract year. So I was really sitting back trying to figure everything out. Like, why am I not playing? Why am I getting jerked around like this? She kind of came up with a solution. Like, look, be on my show, be my boyfriend, get all this fame, blah, blah, blah.
Really?
And for the second, I took the opportunity just because I had a lot of things I wanted to do.
Yeah.
Right. So once I got a feel of it, I was like, you know, this is not for me because I'm not in control.
Right.
I'm not in control of, you know, I don't want to be called Khloe Kardashian's boyfriend for the rest of my life. You know what I mean?
Right.
So I took that and I just canceled it. And pretty much when I said no, you know, they had the camera set up for other shows, spinoff shows. The show that they have now was supposed to be our show.
Gotcha.
But I told them no. So they created the spinoff show with her and her sister going to Miami. And they had to slander my name in order to do so, which is I cheated on her, blah, 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 heartbreak. Let's go to Miami and
make her seem like the victim.
Yeah.
So King Sonny Black, was all this going down when you were in Minnesota?
I had just got traded to Sacramento.
Okay, so you're in Sactown.
Yeah,
okay.
I was in Sactown.
That's interesting. I'm glad you were so open about that because that was something I didn't really know how to, like, if you were going to be kind of sensitive about that.
No,
but
it's open book. I'm an open book. My life is a movie, a real life movie.
But it's good to know.
It's King Sonny Black, baby. King Sonny Black.
Much respect for you speaking on it because a lot of people don't like to be that 100 about those type of things. So basically, she asked you to play a role on a show that would benefit her and then ended up turning on you and making you the bad guy.
Yeah.
That's what you're saying here.
Yeah. Okay. I haven't spoke to her since. I haven't seen her since, but everybody knows what's up.
So were you cool with her mom and Bruce and all the
wasn't really cool. I met him a couple times.
Okay.
But like I said, it wasn't long enough for it to be any kind of serious deal.
You got a phone call.
We have a caller on the line.
Yes. Yeah, what's happening? Welcome to the show.
Hey, what's good, y'all? This is Jason calling from New York.
What's up, Jason from New York?
Not much, man. I've been following you all since last week. Just spreading the word. Glad to see all you all are back on the radio. I don't even listen to the other one anymore since Charlie Under because it's not really funny.
Speak on it.
Congrats to y'all. I'm going to keep spreading the word. Make y'all the top radio show.
Appreciate it, man.
Thank you so much.
Jason in New York.
Appreciate it.
Jason in New York.
We're about to go to break. Before we do,
intro the song.
Sonny Black
King Sonny
Black. King Sonny Black, bitch.
It's King Sonny Black.
Yeah,
TDP. Yeah, you should have said it like that. Hold on. Say it again, TDP.
King Sonny Black, bitch.
We don't have shit in here.
Do we go King to- Sonny Black has brought some music in the studio
yes.
for us. With, and can you tell us about this song, Check For Me?
Of course. Mike, am I on?
Yeah,
you on.
Yeah. It's called Checking For Me. Basically for the ladies.
Oh, and, my goodness, King Sonny. It's soft on me now.
Yeah, it's for the ladies, man. And it's just like a summertime groove. It's a good feel. We make real music.
That's right.
We're not one-dimensional. It's YBG. That's who we are. We're no individuals. We all take maximum credit for just YBG.
Okay, and we want to put the number out there, 323-247-7443. Tell us what you think. Is it a cut or a coaster?
Is it a cut or a coaster? King Sonny Black.
Where's my drink? Let me get my drink. Just in case.
Play it.
Uh-huh. Let's go. Uh-huh.
Shawty, you ain't checking for me. Yeah. Uh-huh. Come on, Shawty, you ain't checking for me. Hey, sweet.